Robin at Tina, Robin at Tina, alang sumadal, layanin ang dagat. Kangi Robin na, Robin at Tina, Robin at Tina, alang sumadal, layanin ang dagat. Yung iba sa mas, maplas na lang de pondons, alang sumadal, nabayin ang dagat. Wow.
It's strange that no one talks about it. The death toll was greater than the Titanic by several hundred people, at least, I think. And I never knew my great-uncle Nigel well. I met him a couple times when I was much younger as a child.
He didn't have any children, and she was like a daughter to him in some ways. He felt that he could relate to her, and he knew that she liked the arts.
So normally I try and go to Paris on the weekends. It works out pretty well handling my workload here because I can work on the airplane, I bring my computer with me, and I'm able to email my professors, but obviously there are sometimes exceptions. I was in Paris for all of Fashion Week.
I don't know how she got into the avant-garde scene, but when she inherited the $350 million from her great uncle, she was able to put all the money into her passion, I suppose.
Yeah, so I mean, I don't really know a whole lot about this girl, but apparently her uncle Nigel passed away and left her a whole bunch of money.
So I heard her great uncle Nigel was some kind of guy who liked water. Water didn't like him very much, but his money liked her.
Now she's going around setting up all these museums and
I have a fourth museum that's due to be opened in the summer of 2014, and it's in Reykjavik.
I heard that her whole family was like kidnapped and held for ransom by Somalian pirates and like slaughtered on TV in front of her. It's crazy. She inherited like $60 billion. And she bought the Louvre.
Now she's rolling around with all this money, and I mean, I guess she's doing all this art stuff with it. If I had money like that, I wouldn't be doing art stuff with it, but...
Really excited when she got this money from Nigel. It was really unexpected. She didn't know what to do with it. But she's always been really into art from a very young age.
Hundreds of millions of dollars. And what does she decide to do with it but go spend it on museums full of all of these paintings that she thinks are cool, but really nobody else has any idea about why they're cool.
So aside from when I have gallery openings, I try and host a lot of these groups, get-togethers really, of philosophical discussions and just talking and wine and food amongst the local artists that I've made connections with. And I think it's helped bring a lot of people together because there are actually a lot of Russian immigrants in Colorado Springs. And I think that this has helped them to become more integrated into the Southwestern artists who are around the area predominantly.
But she's gotten all these Russian artists together, and it's unbelievable. They've all come in from all parts of the world. You know, they're all immigrants. Some of them are from Russia, but others have been in the States for a while, but, you know, their homeland is the Russia.
Springs. I guess I've been painting for all of my life, and at some point I just quit school and started doing that on its own, but of course that didn't really help me get by very easily. So Polly Sinclair discovered me when I was just walking down the street having a conversation with that guy who's always trying to get you to read his writing. You know what I'm talking about?
Obviously where I am, I'm more attuned to local artists from around the Southwest, and I try and incorporate their work especially into the shows that I'm putting on.
There is a cigar in the picture, and it represents power, because usually the cigar is for businessmen. I don't need for a man to guide me in my decisions of life, because I can take my decisions without asking any man, because I'm strong enough.
And there will be a gallery attached to a restaurant, and the seasonal menu of the restaurant will not only use the vegetables from the garden and local other products from local agriculture, but the seasonal menu will somehow reflect the art that is being shown at the gallery at the time.
She has a really good eye, so all of these people are, you know, interesting to talk to. She's pretty involved in the avant-garde and just community building in general, and just she creates a space for kind of weirdos, and she calls it avant-garde, which is great.
Oh, there's the artist.
Generally speaking, I try and concentrate on up-and-coming artists and just those that I've met in the art scene in Colorado Springs and around Colorado and in my travels.
And it's pretty unbelievable because I know, you know, she was just the girl next door essentially, but now she is balling. She's buying the Veuve, she's getting the Moët, and she's throwing parties, and you know, she's being her gregarious self.
Art seems to be her thing. Open up a bunch of museums. I guess that's working for her.
It's really awesome what she's been able to do with her collection.
Spending the money on good things, I guess. I mean, yeah.
She's crazy. She's a crazy, brilliant artist.
And it's unbelievable how she's just launched into this new trajectory. It's just you know.
A dichotomy of feeling, because...
Hmm. Hey.